在哪里工作？Morning from Disney's Animal Kingdom. Thank you for being here this morning. Today we are going to be experiencing some of the new offerings here at Animal Kingdom, as well as learning a little bit more about the Protect the Pride initiative. We are kicking things off with a little bit of breakfast and starting off with a safari. Do me a favor, if you're watching live, thank you for joining us. Don't forget to invite, tag a friend, share it out, sit back, relax, get comfortable, and enjoy the safari with us. even have an assistant today. Nicholas Mongello is here, not just because he's my son and I love him, but I needed somebody to carry the bag.
That's the only reason I'm here.
It's my little mini Sherpa. And yes, today I am testing out a little bit of new equipment. I'm testing out a new stabilizer. So hopefully give you a little bit of a better experience in terms of less bounce, a little bit smoother, a little bit of a better live experience. It's my first day using it, so I'm still getting used to how this whole thing works. But let me know what you think, if you like using the stabilizer versus sort of just me kind of doing it freehand. So again, get comfortable. Thanks for joining me. We're going to be here all morning, both on the safari and then sharing some other things from, I still want to call it Conservation Station and Rafiki's Planet Watch. So Nicholas, come here. All right, so Nicholas, tell me, what is your favorite part of Disney's Animal Kingdom?
The food.
See, that's my son. You said the food. Now you're sad because the sausage that they used to have, that was like a spicy...
It's like this cherry sausage with like a giant sausage corn dog.
That was at the Harami Marketplace?
They used to have the Harami Market.
You know why? We obviously weren't here enough to keep it in business because Animal Kingdom... So hot, so far away. What's your favorite thing to do in Animal Kingdom?
There's lots of toys.
Honestly, just walk around and enjoy like the scenery.
Yes. I said I worked for 4 days and we have Vegas. This is the fifth one we've done. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're seeing something that we don't normally get to see. It's the backside of Jeff. I did. I showed the backside of Jeff. It's not normally seen in the wild. I just got it.
You don't know how to do it live.
No, I never used a gimbal before, so.
Oh.
It has all these buttons and, yeah.
Did you usually just, like,
yeah. So.
You have to let me know how that works out for
me. I mean, it works in terms of the stabilization screen. I'm just trying to figure out the
buttons.
So it depends on the mode. This can either turn it left or right, or it'll just kind of, it'll keep it completely straight.
Amazing.
Yeah.
I need one of those for this. Seriously.
Yeah.
Hey guys, again, Karabuni. Karabuni means welcome in Swahili. Welcome to Kilimanjaro Safaris. How many of you have been on safari with us before? Welcome back, guys. It's great to have you guys return. How many people are new? Oh, there's no one new. That's good. Well, it's really my pleasure to be your safari driver this morning. You know, it's a really exciting day out there today with the Lion King movie opening up this morning, July 19th. What a great day. You know, guys, we've been working on letting people know here at Kilimanjaro about the new Lion King movie opening today, July 19th, and there's a lot of really positive stuff going on with conservation in celebration of that Lion King movie opening up. So it's a really exciting time here at Kilimanjaro Safaris.
Mark, good morning. It's so funny you mentioned Little Red. I remember the entire Little Red storyline when the safari first opened back in 1998. There was an entire scene at the end of the attraction where poachers were trying to kill the elephants, and there was actually a truck at the end that had a live cast member in it where the Little Red was inside, and they had saved... They had captured the captured some of the poachers. There was actually an original scene that was taken out that was a little bit more really sort of explained what happened, a little bit more, maybe even a little graphic. And then they eventually got away from the entire Little Red storyline altogether.
Sante Sana Warden, as we say in the Harambe, we say Twende, which means let's go! Hey, Jumbo everybody, my name's Brian. I'll be your safari guide for your journey through the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. Here on the Harambe Wildlife Reserve, we work toward the preservation of wildlife and engage our guests in conservation. You know, friends, what we see with our eyes, we value in our heart. Directly above you, you'll notice the animal spotting guides. Unfortunately, we won't be seeing all of those animals today because depending on how the animals migrate, we don't always see all of those animals. However, friends, we usually have some pretty good luck. Friends, for your safety and the safety of other guests on your safari today, please remain in your seats for the entire safari. You know, friends, on the count of three, you guys are gonna yell Twende, which means let's go, and your safari here at the Harambe Wildlife Reserve will begin. Are you guys ready for a safari this morning? Okay, guys, on the count of three, you're gonna yell Twende, which in Swahili means let's go. One, two, three! Let's go. Friends, your safari begins here in the Little Ettore Forest. Here in the Little Ettore Forest, these animals' natural colors and markings actually help to keep the animals camouflaged from their predators. Let's see what we can find in the Little Ettore Forest this morning. Friends, on your right-hand side is the beautiful okapi. Although the okapi has a zebra-like stripe on its hindquarters and its front legs, it actually is not related to the zebra at all. It's actually related to the giraffe. It has a skull and a prehensile tongue like the giraffe. Now, friends, I'll teach you a little bit more about the prehensile tongue when we actually see the giraffe. And by the way, we're not going home until we see a giraffe this morning. And I was told this morning I'm packed for a 2-week safari. So you guys don't mind being on safari for 2 weeks, do you? Let's head on into the Ettore Forest, guys. Wow, over there on the left-hand side is the black rhino. The black rhino is the smallest of the rhino family, weighing only 3,000 pounds. Friends, the rhinos today are being poached extensively for their horns. You know, friends, there are only about 5,000 rhinos left in the world. You know, guys, their horns are made out of keratin, which is like your fingernail and hair. Their horns have no scientific or medicinal value to human beings. Guys, on the very top of the bank on your right-hand side, there was a crimson animal up there a second ago. We're going to go around the bend. The animal that's here on the right-hand side is the greater kudu, that tan and grayish animal. It is the second tallest antelope, standing 55 inches tall at its shoulder. Let's go around the bend and see if we can find that other beautiful crimson animal. That animal on the right-hand side, the crimson color, is called the bongo. The bongo's nickname is the ghost of the forest. That's why it's hidden behind the trees and the shrubs. I think they are the neatest animal because they have a strip of hair that stands up on their spine and the stripe actually follows through. Both the male and the female bongo have horns, which is not common. There's another one up there on the tree line at the bank. Not all of the antelope have horns, only the males have the horns. Friends, would you like to see some hippopotamus this morning? I know of a great water hole down near the Safi River where we usually have pretty good luck spotting for the hippopotamus. While we are driving to the Safi River, guys, though, let's brush up on our Swahili. You know, guys, when you guys got to the dock, we said Jumbo. Jumbo actually means hello, and here in the Harambe, it is only polite and proper that when someone says Jumbo to you, that you answer back as loud, if not louder, than the person that wishes you Jumbo. So let's try this, guys. Jumbo, everyone.
Jumbo!
Now, that's a good way to kick off a morning safari. We're going to be traveling pole pole. poli poli means slowly, slowly, while we are looking for the hippo along the Safi River. Guys, the hippo has no sweat glands, so the only way that it can stay cool is by staying submerged in the water. They can actually hold their breath for up to 8 minutes at a time. They will eat between 80 and 90 pounds of foliage a day. Guys, on the right-hand side is the hippopotamus. They will eat to the point that their maximum weight is 5,500 pounds. Guys, on the left-hand side is a group of hippos. Does anyone know what they call a group of hippos? It's actually called a bloat of hippos, B-L-O-A-T. Now, guys, the way that I remember that is that a hippopotamus really does not swim. It actually walks along the banks and it floats, and the word float rhymes with
float,
right? On the island are the pinkback pelicans. The pinkback pelicans get their name because during mating season, we literally can see their pink skin through their feathers, the pinkback pelicans. Now, another reason, friends, for driving pole pole or slowly, slowly is for your safety. Friends, please keep your arms and legs inside the truck. We normally see the Nile crocodiles along the banks of this river, and we don't want any close encounters with those Nile crocodiles. Friends, on your left-hand side are those Nile crocodiles. Those Nile crocodiles will grow to be 16 to 20 feet long, weighing between 500 and 600 pounds. They have the most ferocious bite of any animal. Their bite is equivalent to 2,000 pounds of pressure per square inch. Friends, their bite is bone-crushing. I don't know about you, but no more poli-poli. Let's get out of here. Friends, we're going to travel as far and as fast away from those Nile crocodile. We're going to head on down toward the savannah. Friends, 25 years ago, the Disney's animation team went on a safari and went through the savannah, just like we are today. And the tapestry of life and color and sound and movement and patterns inspired them to create the movie The Lion King. Let's see how we can be inspired by the animals this morning as well. Guys, you're gonna notice that the ecosystem is changing ever so slightly from the little Atori forest to that of the savanna. Not only is the foliage changing on your right-hand side, but even the trees are looking a little bit different. On your right-hand side is the baobab tree. The baobab tree is leafless 9 months out of the year. It also is called the tree of life. And the reason it's called the tree of life is because it can store up to 30,000 gallons of water in its trunk that the animals may need to survive during the dry season here on the savannah. The baobab tree normally lives 2,500 years, but we need conservation because the baobab trees are dying right now prematurely, and we're doing some studies right now to find out why they're dying. Friends, imagine that circle of life. If the animals need water to survive and the baobab tree no longer is there, and how that affects the whole circle. Guys, let's head on into the savannah. See if we can be inspired like the other animation team. This is a beautiful savannah. Guys, I'm seeing a lot of animals out there this morning. What a beautiful day on a safari. Out there you'll see the Maasai giraffe, you'll see the white-bearded wildebeest, and also the springbok. Where do we start? Let's start with the Maasai giraffe, guys, on the right-hand side. The Maasai giraffe will grow to be a towering 20 foot tall, making it the tallest mammal in the world. They have 7 vertebrae in their neck. Ironically, that's how many vertebrae we have in our neck as human beings. But guys, theirs is a little bit larger than ours. We'll talk a little bit more about the Maasai giraffe as we head on into our safari this morning. Over there on the right-hand side, those small antelope are actually known as springbucks. The springbuck, as their name, will spring literally 6 feet in the air and leap 13 feet at the same time. When they run, they look almost like they're flying. They remind me, friends, almost like dolphins in the water as they're cresting. Their front legs are stretched straight out the front and their legs straight out the back. Guys, on the left-hand side on the cave are the painted dogs. Some people refer to these guys as the wild African dogs. you know, friends, I don't find them to be wild at all. You know, I was met with a conservationist by the name of Greg Rasmussen, who actually was telling me that these dogs, actually in the morning when they get awake, they will literally greet one another before they will go out and do their business. The alpha male and alpha female, they're not selected by who is the most powerful or the best hunter. The whole pack will actually choose who they want to be their alpha male and alpha female. Greg Rasmussen, by the way, guys, has been supported by the Disney's Conservation Fund for almost 30 years. I call them the painted dogs. Again, friends, the word Harambe in Harambe Wildlife Reserve means that everything works in harmony. Over here on the left-hand side, you'll notice a termite mound. Even that has a purpose in the circle of life. The termite mound is made up of red clay, saliva, and animal dung. It gets almost as strong as concrete here on the reserve. The elephant actually will use those as scratching posts. So the 13,000-pound elephant will eventually be as tall as that termite mound. Again, friends, directly in front of the truck are those beautiful spring bucks. As I said, check them out on YouTube, guys. Spring buck. And again, they don't run on four legs. They literally will pounce and leap. Directly in front of the truck, guys, is a young baby giraffe. That giraffe was born right here on the safari, on the savannah, about 14 weeks ago. When that baby giraffe was born, it was born 6 foot tall, and within its first hour, it was able to stand and walk. Now, friends, the giraffe has to be 6 foot tall in order to nurse from its mother, because the mother, the adult giraffe, has high metabolism, and they only rest or sleep between 30 and 40 minutes a day, and usually they don't rest laying down because they would be vulnerable to prey. So the baby has to be, the young giraffe has to be that tall in order to nurse. Guys, on the right-hand side, you'll notice the white-bearded wildebeest. Now, guys, the white-bearded wildebeest migrates in a herd of 1.5 million, and they travel between 500 and 1,000 miles per year. You know, guys, their strength in numbers. How do you keep 1.5 wildebeest together for safety? Well, actually, they have scent glands in their hooves, and the last wildebeest can actually smell where the whole herd has traveled. When the Disney's animation team saw these animals running, they were mesmerized for the new Lion King movie opening up this morning, guys. They were mesmerized that they actually did thousands of computerized renderings of the wildebeest running. Friends, I can't wait to see the movie and see how that all pieces together in the new Lion King movie. The wildebeest. Getting back to the discussion of the Maasai giraffe, guys, the Maasai giraffe is identified by its irregular jagged coat, and no two coats are exactly the same. If there's a group of giraffe, friends, it's called a tower of giraffes. Here on the Kilimanjaro Safaris, again, it's our goal to engage people in conservation. Friends, are you aware, seeing all the trees that are downed up ahead, that's a good sign of scouting for the elephants. Are you aware that there are still 96 elephants a day being poached for their ivory? Friends, you heard that correct, 96 elephants a day. Friends, when I did the math, that's about one elephant is poached every 15 minutes. Guys, you know the law of supply and demand. If there's demand, there's supply. Moral of the story, to save the elephant is just refrain from purchasing anything made out of ivory. I'm still seeing a lot of trees down ahead. Let's keep moving forward and see if we can't find some beautiful elephants this morning. Friends, on the right-hand side is that beautiful African elephant. Friends, the African elephant, on the back of their ears, they actually have blood vessels. And by flapping their ears, they can literally lower their body temperature by 15 degrees. Man, I wish on a hot day I'd be able to flap my big ears and lower my body temperature by 15 degrees. How about you guys? Would you guys like to hear a little story about conservation, the Disney's Conservation Fund and the elephants? The elephants were actually stampeding across the farmers' crops, destroying the farmers' income. The farmer, of course, was not very happy. So we actually reached out to the Disney Conservation Fund, and you'll never believe what we found in the results of that research. That huge elephant over there, 13,000 pound elephant, was afraid of the little itsy bitsy bumblebee. So what we did was we taught the farmer to put up a fence line up around the perimeter of his crops, and every so often hang a beehive. If the elephant came too close to the tree, to the fence line, it would send a vibration to the hive. The bees would come out and literally scare the elephants away. It was beautiful, guys. It was a win-win. The farmer preserved his crops. The farmer preserved his income. The farmer actually thought it was a really sweet deal because he got to sell the honey from the honeybees. True story, and thank you to the Disney's Conservation Fund. Let's head onward, guys. We're gonna travel through the red clay pit, see if we can't find more signs of that elephant. Friends, on the right-hand side, you're going to notice that the elephants were just here in the red clay pits, digging in the red clay. The elephants actually will eat that red clay as a mineral subsidy to their diet. So we're on the right path, friends. Let's keep moving forward, see if we can't find more elephants. Guys, on the left-hand side, I'm seeing a little bit of movement. Friends, not only is poaching a serious concern for the life of the elephant, but the elephant is losing thousands and thousands of acres of its habitat because of mining of the mineral coltan. Friends, a 13,000 pound elephant needs thousands of acres of foliage a year just to survive. That coltan that I was talking to you about that they're mining for is used in all of our cell phones, our iPads, and computers, friends. So by recycling, you are actually helping to save the life of those elephants over there. From what I'm being told, coltan can be used over and over again. It never goes bad. There's some more beautiful elephants over there on the left. You'll notice the elephant has dirt on his back. The elephant actually throws dirt on his back, not for good luck, but the dirt actually acts as sunscreen so the elephant will not get sunburned. What a beautiful animal. He must be a little warm. He's flapping his ears. Now, guys, I said that the animals actually would drink from the baobab tree. The animals themselves actually will chew on the branch and the roots, which actually become a straw. The elephants have another idea to get to the water. They literally will dig into the center of the tree to get to the water. You'll notice that the elephants were trying to dig into both of these trees. The bark and the tree itself is actually rather soft. We're gonna stop here and give you guys a photo op. What a beautiful animal. 13,000 pounds. On your left-hand side, friends, are the greater flamingos. The greater flamingos, friends, get their beautiful pink color because of their diet. They eat brine shrimp, and brine shrimp is high in beta carotene, turning their feathers that beautiful color pink. Friends, you know what they call a group of flamingo? They're called a flamboyance of flamingo. Try saying that five times real fast, guys. Flamboyance, flamingo, flamboyance, flamingo, flamboyance, flamingo, flamboyance, flamingo. Okay, I've had a little bit of practice, guys. We're gonna be heading over into the eastern part of the savanna. The animals here are a little different than on the west side. Let's see what we can be inspired by this morning. Friends, on the left-hand side is a huge mud hole. And directly in front of the truck, friends, is the largest of the rhino family, known as the white rhino. Hold on one second, friends.
West County.
Friends, I apologize for the inconvenience. Of course, the animals here on the Harambe Wildlife Reserve actually have the right of way. So actually this is positive because it gives us a little bit more time to admire the beauty of these animals. Guys, these are called the Veid Rhino. The Veid Rhino were actually given their name by the Germans who actually colonized the southern part of Africa. When the Germans saw this animal, they called it the Veid Rhino because it has a really wide snout, and the word Veid means wide. You know, as the decades passed, it was shortened up to the White Rhino. However, the color white has absolutely nothing to do with the White Rhino. These guys weigh between 4,000 to 5,000 pounds, and they can run at a crashing speed of 30 to 34 miles per hour. Friends, imagine that, an animal weighing 5,000 pounds running up to 34 miles per hour. A group of rhino, friends, is called a crash. A crash of rhino. How beautiful are they? They are huge. We're gonna travel pole pole. Friends, we're going to head on over to the kopje. The kopje is a tall stone structure where the larger mammals like to hang out the scope for the prey down here in the lower land of the savannah. Guys, you know that I'm talking about the lions. Friends, one century ago, 100 years ago, there were over 200,000 lions in the wild. Guys, when the first Lion King movie came out 25 years ago, there were only 40,000 lions in the wild. Today, friends, sad to say, there are only 20,000 lions in the wild. Friends, with the opening of the new Lion King movie opening up today, it is the Disney's Conservation Fund goal in celebration of the new movie to actually increase the pride by 20,000 to 40,000 by the year 2050. Friends, if you're interested in getting involved in protecting the pride, stop by any of the merchandise establishments here in the Harambe. The Wildlife Conservation Fund, Disney's Conservation Fund, will match any contribution dollar for dollar, and you'll receive a beautiful pin to wear with pride that you support wildlife conservation. Friends, on the left-hand side are the Bonte bucks. The Bonte bucks are almost extinct in the wild. There are only 250 of them on reserves like ours today. Speaking of protecting the pride, friends, you know, thank you so much for being on safari today, because the Disney's Conservation Fund, for every guest we take on safari today through July 25th, they will donate $2 for every guest that we have on the truck with us, up to the total maximum of donation of $350,000. It is our goal here at Kilimanjaro of the safari drivers to match that within those days, July 19th. To the 25th, friends. On the left-hand side, friends, is the Pride of Lions. The lions actually will rest between 14 and 16 hours a day, preparing to do their hunting at night. Well, that's not totally true. The females do the hunting at night. The male lion, they just hang out in the man cave. Ba-dum-bum. Okay, friends, we need to travel on. Let's see what else we can see today. Friends, if I have any wilderness explorers on my truck on page 15, in order to get your safari merit badge, you guys need to know the name of my truck. My favorite animal is that lion over there, so I gave my truck the Swahili name for Lion. This is for all the kids and the kids at heart that are on my safari today. The name of my truck is Simba1, S-I-M-B-A-1, roar! All right, friends, that's supposed to be funny, and I'm still working on my roar. Guys, on the left-hand side is the warthog. Friends, again, when the animation team saw the warthog, they saw how light it would walk with a bounce and a little bit of a lilt with its tail straight up in the air. Of course, you know that the animation team mimicked the warthog for what character in the Lion King movie? Its name is Pumbaa. The warthog is related to the domesticated pig. However, they are smarter, in my opinion, than the average pig. They will back themselves into a burrow, keeping their razor-sharp tusks to the front to deter the predators from poking their heads in their burrows. Let's keep heading onward, guys, see what we can find. Friends, on the right-hand side, you'll see that the ostrich overnight left us some eggs. Those ostrich eggs there on the right-hand side weigh an average of 3 pounds apiece, equivalent to 2 dozen chicken eggs. Friends, those shells are so tough that I'd be able to do a tap dance routine on top of all of those eggs, and they would not crack or break. However, friends, do me a favor this morning. Take my word for it, because you really don't want to see me tap dancing on those ostrich eggs this morning. We're going to head on into the Mogoti Glen. The Mogoti Glen is similar to that of the Torrey Forest. It is forest-like. However, the humidity is high, meaning that there must be some water close by. Let's head into the Mogoti Glen. Friends, it's time for your Kilimanjaro Safari quiz. Are you guys ready? You get 4 questions. Let's see how well you do this morning. First question, what do you call a group of hippopotamus? It is called a bloat. Good job. That's number one. Number two, what do you call a group of giraffes? A tower of giraffes. Number three, what do you call a group of flamingo?
A flamboyance.
And last, for 100%, what do you call a group of rhino?
A crash.
Excellent job. You guys got 100%. Friends, on your left-hand side, laying on top of the bank, is a scimitar-horned oryx. A scimitar-horned oryx has the longest antlers of any antelope. Its antlers are approximately 5 to 6 feet long. Friends, you know, you had an awesome safari this morning. We saw a lot of beautiful animals again. Thank you so much for being here and being on safari and helping to support the donation of $2 per member on the safari today toward our $350,000 goal. You know, guys, I'd like to encourage everyone, please recycle those cell phones and electronics and computers and help save the life of the elephants. You know, guys, the majority of the animals that we saw this morning on safari seriously are endangered species. So I leave you with a few questions. If we don't get involved in conservation, friends, who will? And will these beautiful animals be around for future generations to admire and be inspired if we don't get involved in conservation? You know, friends, I'm really excited, and I'd like to give credit to you guys. You know what, guys? Since 1995, generous guests like you that have donated toward protecting the pride in the Disney's Conservation Fund with the Disney's matching contribution, the Disney Conservation has raised over $75 million toward wildlife conservation. That's something to be really proud of, guys, and we need to continue to protect the pride and increase those numbers from 20,000 to 40,000 by the year 2050. Friends, thank you so much for being here today. It truly was my honor and pleasure to take you guys on safari this morning. On behalf of Kilimanjaro Safaris, my name is Brian. I'd like to say that it is my hope that the beautiful animals that you guys saw this morning on your safari, you will treasure in your hearts forever. We don't say goodbye because goodbye is too final. So we actually say kwa harini, which means go well, friends, until we meet again. On behalf of Kilimanjaro Safaris, guys, thank you so much for everything that you guys do. And come back and see us again sometime here at Kilimanjaro Safaris. Thanks again, guys. Kwa harini. Thank you. Friends, as we're getting ready to dock, you may want to gather your belongings. Also, when you do step off the truck, double check and make sure that nothing has fallen out of your pockets on the truck as you disembark. Holding. Hey guys, kuishi, kwa amani, go in peace, guys. Go out there in the world, help make a difference, help us save these beautiful animals, and have a great day in the Harambe. Thanks for being here, guys. You're welcome. Have fun.
Thank you very much. You were an exceptional tour guide today.
Thank you so much. My pleasure. Don't forget Simba 1. Get that story very badge, guys. Take care, guys.
He was great. He was a great guy. You know, the it's funny because the safari drivers are a lot like your Jungle Cruise skippers. Like, for the most part, they have a script that they have to stay to, but they can make it so much their own and add a little bit to it. And I thought he was excellent. I love the addition of some of the additional information in terms of the conservation efforts, as well as the movie that's coming out today. And it's neat that they donate $2. Yeah, so they donate $2 for every guest on the safari that rides. So every time you ride, you're helping too. If they only did that for food, I'd be set. Oh, look, look, look. Oh, let's go see the gorilla. Come here. Sorry, man. Go ahead.
Welcome.
He was just there. We just missed him.
Here's a great picture.
I need one of those in my backyard.
Yeah.
I need a little waterfall in my backyard. A grotto, as it were. I know. Good morning. Well, I got the things. Toasty here at Disney's Animal Kingdom.
Okay, I want to do the play-up.
All right, Nicholas, important questions for you. One, yeah. What is your favorite attraction at Disney's Animal Kingdom?
Flight of Passage.
Okay.
One answer.
Now, the next question is the one that's really going to make or break our relationship. What's the best thing to eat at Disney's Animal Kingdom?
Do they have to still be here?
Yes, it has to still be here. I know you miss the sausage at Harambe Marketplace. All right, let's we'll start big and work our way down. Best restaurant at Disney's Animal Kingdom.
Chick-fil-A.
The Thule Canteen. Yes, Thule Canteen. Like I love Tiffin's. I love Nomad Lounge, which you've never been to before. But I think for just overall like food I enjoy the most, it's got to be Thule Canteen. And the new make your own bowl, like the way they do it now, even better. I have to think I'll go back and re-review it again. So when's the last time you've done this? When's the last time you've been to
months.
Conservation Stage in months? I think it's been years for me. I don't think I remember the last time I've been here. Probably because there's not a restaurant. If there was a restaurant here, it would get me here a lot longer. Because you know what they have that a lot of other places that Animal Kingdom don't have? Air conditioning. Air conditioning.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Whatever. Oh. I think we're good. So, yeah, I haven't been here in years, but from what I understand, there's new experiences here, which we're going to see. They're not dining experiences, but they're experiences nonetheless. I'm always hungry. I know. I have a one-track mind. But I always like this. I think there's something, like all the train rides, I think there's something elegant in its simplicity. It doesn't tell you what mode it's in, so I can't tell. I have to like, just sort of guess.
Greetings, friends, and welcome aboard the Wildlife Express. For a safe journey, remember to stay seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. Sit all the way back against the bench, and please be sure to watch your shoulders. Asante.
Bienvenidos a bordo del Wildlife Express. Para que tengan un viaje seguro, manténganse sentados con las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro de la banca. Siéntense hasta atrás, pegados a un respaldo de la banca. Y por favor, vigilen a los niños. Gracias.
Welcome aboard the Wildlife Express with service to Rafiki's Planet Lunch. Here, you'll discover a wide range of animal adventures from the affection section, where you can get up close and personal with domesticated animals like goats, sheep, and more, to sneak peeks at animal care in action at our veterinary, nutrition, and science centers. Also, be sure to check out the animation experience at Conservation Station, where you can learn to draw your favorite Disney characters inspired by live animals from one of our animators. The tradition of animals and animation reaches all the way back to Walt Disney himself and his long-standing passion for conservation. He believed it was important that we protect our wildlife and preserve our natural world. This sense of motivation shaped his legacy from animation to conservation to the very adventures we offer here at Disney's Animal Kingdom each and every day. As we make our way to Rafiki's Planet Watch, keep an eye out for some of the exciting wildlife we might encounter along the way and the highly trained specialists who care for them. From ostriches and rhinos to the mighty African elephant, the species we care for here at Disney's Animal Kingdom are some of the very same animals that inspired animated classics like The Lion King, The Jungle Book, and more. show continues today as animators travel throughout the world to observe animals in their own surroundings. And that includes here in Disney's Animal Kingdom. We are now approaching Conservation Station at Rafiki's Planet Watch. For your safety and the safety of those around you, please sit all the way back against the bench and avoid leaning out toward the railing. Remain seated until the train comes to a complete stop, and please be sure to watch your children as you exit. Go well and explore.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Jumbo friends, welcome to the Conservation Station. Please sit back and realize until our cast members open the doors for you. Please do not open the doors by yourself. Thank you so much. I have a wild name.
Ladies first. That's all right. I would never put anybody's butt on camera that didn't sign a waiver first, don't worry. Thank you. Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out the different settings on here. Good morning. I literally don't remember the last time I was here at Rafiki's Planet Watch and Conservation Station. For those of you who are watching, when you come to Animal Kingdom, is this something you do every time? Is it a one and done? And when was the last time you were here? Here it comes. Yeah, baby. Come on. Bring it. Oh, yeah. Oh, sweet baby Jesus air conditioning. You have to use the restroom? Except they care for that one here. Good morning.
Sorry.
Get a pencil.
Thank you. Thank you. Get one. No, you're supposed to get one.
Right over here.
Where am I? Can I sit?
No!
Thank you.
Sit.
Thank you.
Hey guys, just come right on down this way.
We're gonna see.
Right on down this way. Yep, all the way down, everyone. We're gonna pull in the second row right over here. Hey, all the way down for us, please. All the way down. We're gonna pull in the second row.
How many you got?
All the way down.
How many two? With you? Two of you?
Four.
We're gonna go down this way, all the way to the end.
Oh, this is not going to end well, I can tell.
This way, guys, this way!
There's animals everywhere.
Get to know them, you're going to be bumping elbows for about 30 minutes.
All the way down.
Are you with them? You're next. Come on down. Make sure you have a good view of that screen. You don't need to see our
screen. I'm a little nervous about this. This is very much outside the area of my what little expertise I have. This is not No, not at all.
Right this way?
Tardy.
Oh, she's already here.
Tardy.
Anybody else? No?
Oh, yeah,
a few more. Right down this way, guys? Yeah? Here you go, right in here.
And if you're watching live, do me a favor. Why don't you take a break for a second and see if you want to tag and invite somebody to come and join with us, not only to experience the animation experience, but just to see how bad my artistic lack of talent is going to be. I don't remember the last time I was at Conservation Station.
Somehow we got five seats over here, so. Not counting the last couple rows. Five seats are. Yeah. In case we need to throw some.
Attention animators, in just 10 minutes, you're invited to take part in the animation experience right here at Conservation Station, where you'll learn to draw one of your favorite characters with the help of one of our very own Disney artists. Get ready, the animation experience takes place under the atrium in just 10 minutes.
Right down here. Okay. Oh, all the way down. How many you got? Five? Right there. Everybody stop for a moment. Five of you right there. Everybody else, gonna start that front row. Beep, 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 beep.
So tell me, what is your favorite? Whoops.
Well, she's still gonna turn upside down.
What is
she's
your
gonna,
favorite?
It's a challenge. It's a challenge.
What's your favorite show at Disney's Animal Kingdom?
The handle.
Festival of Lion King or Finding Nemo? All right, we'll do this or that. Festival of Lion King or Finding Nemo?
Oh, you're going. Look at this.
Festival
of Lion
King.
No, guys. Interesting.
Satuli Canteen or Harambe Market? Expedition Everest or Kilimanjaro Safari? Navi River Journey or Navi River Journey or Safari? Expedition Everest or Flight of Passage?
If you want.
Flight of Passage or Kilimanjaro Safari? Flight of Passage or Satuli Canteen? Satuli Canteen. Or Nomad Lounge. Oh, you haven't been in Nomad Lounge.
I have been in Nomad Lounge.
Oh, Nicholas, it's so good. I'm never taking your Tiffins. Nomad Lounge is really good. Although, I need to go back and redo my live review because everything that was there is gone.
Please, come down.
Which usually happens. It's my live reviews are sometimes the kiss of death.
And so far, they haven't bitten anybody.
Have you been back to Nomad since we did the review? Does your messenger or phone not work?
No, I tell you.
Is the menu very different than?
It's very different.
Better or worse?
Still amazing. Like it's my favorite. It's probably my favorite spot right now.
It's just so far away. If they had like an air conditioned like monorail to Nomad Lounge.
I used for the first time.
I did
today.
Too. I didn't know where I was going.
I was like hoping
always
I was in the
always watching.
Just come on around, folks, and then come on in.
Yeah, I didn't know where the new road was going to take us, but we were. I was half asleep, so it didn't matter. We just took it anyway.
Let us off a cliff for all we knew.
Just like The Price is Right, but no Drew Carey. No prizes. Okay, it's nothing like The Price is Right, but come on down anyway.
I think I'm going to need my glasses for this necklace.
I am a guy with glasses from Ohio, so I guess I count. My name's not Drew. We draw.
Nicholas, they said, he is his father's son.
Wait, Nicholas?
You. Oh. Wait, so what's your overall favorite restaurant in Walt Disney World? If you could only eat in one restaurant, what is it?
Boathouse.
You are your father's son. Okay, other than, let's say, Boathouse out of the equation.
Smile, it's free.
Favorite restaurant in Walt Disney World? Well, that's why I'm asking you, so think about it. Assuming that money and air conditioning was not an issue. It's very hot in Animal. It's very hot in Animal Kingdom every day. It's really hot in Animal Kingdom today.
Stupid hot.
So any restaurant. Satouli Canteen, California Grill. What about, we haven't been there in a long time, but what about, oh God, Wilderness Lodge, the Wilderness Lodge outside, Geyser Point.
That's not my favorite.
I know, but it's so nice out there when it's not 1,000 degrees outside.
That's the thing, it's always 1,000 degrees outside.
I can't wait for December. Too much for December.
It's going to be 89 degrees in December.
I know, it'll be cool compared to today.
I know you're all looking for a wide clipboard. The animators had an extra clipboard when they went out to the wild, the ones where they had wildlife and their guests. We are. We have to show you how to do it.
So again, if you guys don't mind sharing out that we're going to be participating in the Animation Experience at Conservation Station, which I believe began just about a week or so ago. Not even, just a few days ago. So this is a very new experience, not just for them, but certainly for me as well.
We'll see if we can get a side-by-side on that.
Nicholas, somebody just said top 10 Walt Disney World restaurants.
I can't even think of one. You want me to think of 10?
That's a top 10 that I can't do with Tim, because he doesn't eat anywhere. Tim doesn't go anywhere.
California Grill.
I haven't eaten there in a long time.
California Grill. Also, we like Ale and Compass. We don't want too expensive. If you don't want super expensive, but you want good food.
For dinner or breakfast or lunch?
Anything.
Have I been there for dinner?
I don't know. Well, you can get like a burger or fish and chips or whatever. Really
to hold your stuff?
California Grill. This is an unofficial. Well, let's just put Boathouse at the top and just go from there. Boathouse, California Grill, Nomad Lounge, Homecoming.
You'll be alright, right?
I don't know. I don't know.
Flying Fish. I think I put Flying Fish.
I haven't been to Flying Fish in years. I would potentially put Satouli Canteen on there because I like it that much.
That's the best quick service. Yeah, it's the best quick service.
Best kids meal. Wait. God, it just jumped out of my head.
What? Polite Pig?
That's one of the best.
Polite Pig?
What Polite Pig?
I think, in terms of quick service, thank you, Tangerine Cafe.
Those are my top three quick service.
Raglan Road.
Raglan Road could be up there.
Always has good food. I like Marmo Asia, but not everyone does.
What else? Top 10 restaurants in Walt Disney World.
Narcoozies.
I don't eat very much. I don't know if Narcoozies would make my top 10. I haven't been there in a few years. There's actually a few restaurants I haven't been to like in a long time. I haven't been to Haleo yet. I haven't tried Haleo in Disney Springs. Let's see. Oh, Sanaa, Flame Tree.
Sanaa's
Red Service at Sanaa.
Boma
for breakfast.
Yeah.
Boma breakfast. Geyser Point. I agree. I really liked Geyser Point. I haven't been to B. Arquesta. There's brunch at Narcoozies?
Narcoozies is my favorite.
There's a brunch at Narcoozies? That's what she said.
I still haven't done California Girls brunch.
I have another idea. I've been to Toledo, but just not. I haven't had a full meal. Oh, Skipper Canteen.
I love Skipper.
Homecoming. I agree about Homecoming. Yeah. Homecoming brunch is so good. Vianopoli Tapanetto. Might as well go to Pit Boma while you're that close. I know. I would if I could.
To the animation experience at Conservation Station. Since the 1930s, Disney animators have put their pencils to paper in service of the idea that the greatest inspiration often comes from the magic of nature. Walt Disney himself understood the importance of spending time around animals, studying their behavior and personalities in order to create realistic characters and dynamic storylines. This meeting of the human and animal worlds sparked a legacy of storytelling that has shaped our relationship with animals and conservation forever. Today, we invite you to become part of that legacy as our own Disney artists help you learn to sketch characters inspired by the very animals found here at Disney's Animal Kingdom. Get your pencils ready, because here comes our animation artist now.
Hey, everyone, good morning! Wow! Usually the morning crowd is always like... I'm glad you guys are awake, right?
Yeah.
I like interactive classes. Yay! Excellent. Well, everyone, welcome. Some of you may have never done the animation experience before. So if you've never been here before, basically we're going to give you the experience to be a Disney animator. Okay? Which is why you have clipboards. Yes?
Yes.
Which is why you have paper. Yes. And pencils. Yes? All right. Well, some of the things that we need are some of the things that Walt Disney himself actually did. You see, when Walt Disney did a lot of the animated films, they would bring in subjects to kind of influence the artists and also kind of get them ready and inspired to draw those characters. And especially with animals, he would actually bring real animals into the studio, and he would actually have the artist draw those real animals, and from that, we would get the characters that we know today. So today, we're gonna give you that opportunity, okay? So first, I would like to introduce you to our inspiration that we're going to draw from. So everyone, watch our inspiration, and I'll tell you who we're gonna draw.
Meet Takari, an African lion. He may not look too busy if you come to visit him during the heat of the day. Being a carnivore, he is doing just what he needs to do. His strategy? It may be similar to some teenagers you know, laying down and resting to conserve energy. Lions can sleep up to 20 hours a day. Takari has this down to an art form. With his schedule, Lion turns out to be a perfect name. Takari likes to lie in grass, lie in rocks, lie in a shady spot. Takari seems to get comfortable anywhere. In the wild, food is hard to come by. Not that a male lion would know. The lionesses typically do the hunting and all the caregiving for the family. With all that the females do for the pride, you may be asking, what exactly does this leave for the males to do? Oh yeah, there's that. And more of that. the protector with a roar heard for miles. Takari will usually instigate all the noise. Soon after, Kumari and Kinsey will join in, wanting the primes together. His keepers say Takari's roar is distinctive and purposeful. What is made clear to all? He is the defender of his territory and his family. Lions in the wild are struggling due to conflict with people, over resources, and loss of habitat. The Disney Conservation Fund has supported lion conservation for over 20 years, helping organizations find solutions that benefit people, lions, and their habitats across 8 countries. Come visit Takari on the Kilimanjaro safaris to see him in action or not in action. Learn more about lions and how you can help. Now that is something to roar about.
All right, so we saw our inspiration. So who are we drawing? That's right. And we're not just drawing any Simba. We're drawing Lion Cub Simba. Aw, yeah, we're going to Lion Cub Simba. Now, the reason we showed you that, Takari...
This is not going to work out well for me.
...really get the look of a lion. It's going to be very important as we draw Simba, okay? So, let's go ahead and get started. Now, you may notice that you have already here a circle and some... Oh, by the way, if at any time during the class you do need to get new pencils, because your pencil breaks, please raise your hand. And let one of my friends go around here. He'll be more than happy to help you out, okay? Now, like I said, you'll see you have circles here and you have guidelines, okay? So we don't have to draw all that. We have that all done for you. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, you may notice that you don't have erasers. That's because, like I said before, we're treating you like Disney animators, which means you don't need erasers. Disney artists don't use erasers, okay? So, draw very, very lightly, and then when you get home, you feel free to draw it again, okay? So, go here to the middle of the circle. You'll see two guidelines here in the middle, okay? I'm going to draw a very, very light line from the end of the top line to the bottom. Very, very lightly. This is kind of being a barrier. Now, one of the most striking things about a lion is their eyes.
I need an eraser.
So that's the first thing we're going to draw. In fact, most of this class...
How did I screw this up already?
...drawing these eyes, okay? So first, we're going to draw in the iris. And this is a circle about the size of a nickel, like a U.S. nickel. It goes right here. And you'll see that the nickel actually ends right where you put that very light circle. Now, the good thing about drawing lines...
Understand that I'm also holding the camera.
Because when you draw it in those lines, that those light lines are going to disappear completely. Okay? Next, we're going to go in and draw in the pupils, which are the exact same shape. That's smaller.
My Baymax looks awesome.
You want them nice and big because you want Simba to look cute. He's a lion cub, so he has to look cute. Now, if you ever see a lion cub in the wild, go
pet it. Wait.
I actually got a chance to actually see Takari, and we were 6 feet away from him, and I was already a little bit intimidated.
It's good.
Linus and some of them just didn't like that we were near, and she was growling the whole time. So, you know, I was 6 feet away, and I just thought I'd back up a couple more feet, you know, just in case, you know. But let me tell you, they're very impressive animals. Very impressive. All right, inside the eyes, we're going to add in the pupils. We're going to add a little shine, sorry. They're just little circles within the circle. bonus circle session. This is the light that shines on the eyes. And then you can go ahead very quickly. I want you to shade in those pupils. Don't shade in the whole thing, just the inner one. And make sure you don't shade in the little circle you just drew. Now the whites of the eyes, which are drawn like a little bit of a crescent moon shape above each of the pupils here. So we're just going to draw in a little crescent moon shape. How wide should you make it, you may ask? Well, you should just use the end of that first guideline at the top.
Nice.
There. That'll help you make sure you make it wide enough. We're also going to draw some eyelashes. So at the top of the eye, what you're going to do is just draw a very bold line. Very bold curve that goes into the eye. Into the eyelashes.
Left my drawing. Simba's having a bad day.
Next is tear duct that starts at the edge of the eyes. Now all you want to draw is a little funnel shape that goes from the eyes down to that second guideline there in the middle. Just so that we're clear, it's a funnel shape, not funnel cake. It's completely different. Next is what we call the mask. This is the lighter part of the fur that goes around the eyes, okay? So what you're going to do, and you can do it one of two ways. You can just eye it yourself, or if you want to, you can draw a very light line from the middle of the pupil all the way over towards the circle. Either way is fine. Okay? So we're going to draw an arch that starts at the end of the tear duct there, and you're just going to go around the top and then stop right where you stop with that light line.
I can't do that.
You're eyeing it. Purposeful mistake, just so that you can see I'm doing this for realsies. That was on purpose and not by accident. All right, now we're going to draw a little curve that goes from the bottom, opposite of the tear duct, all the way to the end of where you drew the mask.
I need an eraser.
I feel like you need an eraser.
It's good.
We're also going to draw the
eyebrows. This one's really good. The right one's really good.
And they're just the little arch that goes under the arch that you just drew. Make that a little bit thicker at the top. Now,
I'm going to get my brows like mine.
Over and over and over and over again as we draw Simba. I don't know if you knew this, but lions are furry. So we're going to add some fur at the top. I know, mind blown, right? And you can quickly shade that in too once you're done. And believe it or not, lions' eyesight are just as good as ours during the day. However, at night, they're much, much better. And one of the reasons why is because of the next part that we're going to draw. The bottom part, it's a new shape that goes from the bottom of the tear duct all the way to the other side of the mask. Now, why is this part so important? Well, this light patch of fur actually catches moonlight, which makes it easier for the lion to see because they're nocturnal hunters, which means they hunt at night.
Nicholas, you're not supposed to be drawing a furry. You're supposed to be really drawing fur. It's very different. Furry is what you see at MegaCon, not what you see at MegaCon.
All right. Next, we're going to draw in the nose. Now, the nose starts
beautiful.
Off very lightly as little curves that start at the tear duct that you drew. Okay? You're just going to draw a little curve that goes right down to this line right here, the small one that goes out of the circle near the bottom. Draw very lightly. Okay. We're gonna draw the bottom of the nose, which is a V shape. It's a curved V because Simba is not a villain. So we do not want any part of him to be sharp. Especially since he's a young lion cub. We do not want any part of him to be sharp. We want him to look cute. Now, the top of Simba's nose makes the whole bottom part of the nose kind of look like a boomerang. And if you're not exactly sure how to draw a boomerang shape, if you wait a few minutes, it will come back to you.
Oh, boy.
Some of you took longer than others. Lions have a very good sense of smell. In fact, they mark their territory using scent glands that they have located in their cheeks, their foot pads, and the end of their tail.
Dude, it's good. It's better than mine.
All right. We're going to add a little detail to this nose. First, I'd like to go to the top and add some wrinkles. On the left side. The nostrils, which are small little sunflower seeds at the bottom of the nose. And you can quickly shade those in, too, once you're done. Once you got all that in place, you can go ahead and start
that's
putting
supposed
the
to be
sides with the nose.
It looks like a pain.
Now, next we're going to draw in that powerful lion jaw, okay? Now this starts at the end of the iris here, and we're going to draw in a very, very small, very, very light line that goes right down past the circle toward that last guideline at the bottom there. Very, very light. Also very lightly, we'll just draw in a little smile that connects the two. It kind of looks like the bottom of a marshmallow. Now we're gonna draw in the sides of the smile there. And what you can do is you can start right where the tear duct is, and you can draw a really long curve. Just all the way down to that really long line. And then kind of curves again. So it's like a really far away seagull. All right. No? Nobody got that? All right, that's all right. We're moving on. You're concentrating, that's all right. All right, next we're going to draw the smile. Now, the ends of that curve that you drew, those are the dimples, okay? So, first, we're going to draw in the middle of the smile, which is going to ironically start off as a frown in the middle there. Okay, then starting in the middle of this part of dimple there, okay, you're just going to draw in a curve that connects to the end there. By the way, you may hear sound effects. Sound effects actually do help artists draw better. It's like tennis. All right. Now let's darken the sides of that jaw. Now start right in the smile there and just trace your line to get all the way down to the end. We're going to draw in three little pieces of fur. Don't forget to darken in the bottom as well. Ears, okay? Now the ears are just about as long as the end of the mask to the circle. So I'll teach you a little artist trick, okay, to measure them correctly. Take your pencil, put down on the paper, okay? Put the tip where the circle is, okay? Put your finger where the mask is, and move your pencil over, okay? Right there, how long that ear should be. So then take your finger and press on the end of the pencil there and make a little mark. Okay?
I don't have enough hands to do this.
We'll do the same for the other side.
I'm eyeballing it. Yeah, I'm eyeballing this.
How many of you like coffee? Okay, then you should know the shape of this next part. Now, this is a kind of shape like the handle of a coffee mug. Okay? So start near the top of the head there, and you're just going to draw in coffee mug handle.
Oh my. That's not good.
Make sure you draw very lightly.
That's okay. Everybody's is.
How many of you have seen the movie Moana? Great. So this next part is going to be drawn like Maui's hook.
Slow down, okay? Man. I'm not there yet.
So Lion's ears are folded in a little bit. So start right where the end of the mask is there. And just draw in hook.
Dude, wait. Vervain. What did I miss? Oh, now I'm way behind.
Now very lightly, I want you to draw it a C shape. It was inside each side of the ears. Trace over the sides of the ears and add a little bit of fur. Let's see for this side here. And then the inside, you also want to do the same thing. Draw in those cheeks. Now, there is two ways to do this, and I'm going to show you both ways, and you can do whatever you feel comfortable doing. Okay? So, first part, you start very lightly, right where you started the fold in the ear there, and you just start to draw an S curve. It comes out of a circle, and it comes down and attaches to the chin.
Uh-oh.
Once you're done, go back
what?
And trace
Wait,
it.
What?
Add in
I'm way behind. I missed something.
Fur.
Can we start again?
Or
wait, what?
You could just go ahead and draw fur right straight out. If you're confident enough. Draw the rest of the chin after you're done. That's totally up to you.
I missed a whole step. I literally missed a step.
No, it's bad. At least yours looks better than this disgusting.
All right, now we're going to draw Simba's mane, or what he calls his mane. He's a cub, so he doesn't really have a mane yet. But this is what he calls it. Anyways, I'm going to start at the top of the head and just start drawing the top part of that circle.
I give up.
When you get to near the top there, we're just going to draw three little patches of hair. I say three, I don't mean three. The good thing is, you can just have fun with this little hair, these little pieces of hair, and you just have them go all over the place. And then trace on this side, just the rest of the head.
Whoops.
Finally, we're going to add in a line that goes from the bottom of the nose to the top of the smile there. We need the cat, of course. We need to add those whiskers in. So I like to draw three on one side, four on the other.
Well, Simba looks pissed.
And throw as far as well as three little hairs inside the ears. I'm just throwing the little eyelashes and then shade the dark parts of Simba's ears. If you don't finish this up, that's okay, don't worry about it.
He has a much better pencil.
Remember that your paper is compatible with any number two pencil, and you don't need to buy any upgrades for it.
This is a horror show.
Now, before we end the class, folks, I want you to pause for just a moment. Just a moment. I want you to look at your drawing.
Dude, that's really good.
If you're saying to yourself right now, man, I don't like my drawing,
man,
congratulations, you're on your way to becoming a good artist. Because no artist ever likes their drawings. But now, if you look over here to your right, you will see a window of some of our company's greatest animators. And they're doing exactly what you have done in this class today. You have watched a real animal, you've taken inspiration, and now you've drawn a cartoon character based on that animal. So you should be very proud of yourself. So give yourself a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. So one more thing you need to add, and this is the most important, your name. So don't forget to add your name. That's the most important part of any drawing, is your
name. Can I
name.
Add somebody else's name?
Don't write someone else's name. Today's date is 7/19/19.
The only good part of my drawing is my signature.
Here, folks, I would like to thank you so very much for joining us here for this class. And I want to encourage those of you who really like to draw, who have fun, to go out there and draw as much as you can. Because the only way you can get better is to keep on drawing. So thank you guys so much for joining us. I hope you guys had fun. And come back to see us again soon because we have classes throughout the day, all right? Have a good day, everyone. Bye!
Thank you all for joining us in the animation experience at Conservation Station. Please gather your personal belongings before exiting, leaving the clipboard and pencil at your seat.
There's the grand reveal.
We hope you enjoy the rest of your visit at Rafiki's
Flat. I mean, it could have been better. A lot better.
Goodbye.
Nicholas, let's see yours.
No one should be cursed with
come on.
Image.
I want to see it.
No.
Show it.
No.
Show it. Do it.
Nobody should be cursed with
you have to
image
do it.
In their mind.
I'll never take you to Animal Kingdom. I'll never take you to Thule Canteen again. Just give me it.
Look how beautiful it is, everybody.
You drew an invisible ink? Listen, if I could show mine, you could show yours.
Trust me, mine looks a lot worse.
Grandpa's looks good.
Here, yeah, take that. You're in charge of.
You want to know what place? Don't worry.
Did you get it? Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.
Fend for yourself. You're almost going to be 14, Nicholas, so...
No, don't say that.
Almost. Couple more days. Oh, Nicholas, remember when you used to go to Animal Kingdom camp?
I was never a rat.
Oh. My son used to go to, this is an Animal Kingdom camp for the children of cast members. I had a cast member friend who was able to get my kids into Animal Kingdom camp. Where are you? How much did you love Animal Kingdom camp?
It was so much
fun. What kind of stuff did you do there?
We went swimming in the Nemo tank.
Did you really? Did you really?
Yeah.
Wait, I didn't know that.
Some of the other grades went like horseback riding, and you get to go around the parks. You get animals come into class. You get to go behind the scenes of the safari and get to see all the animal enclosures.
Oops. Hey. Hold on. Oops. Sorry.
But those are like the best things that you do there. So wow. Much fun.
Yeah, you miss Animal Kingdom camp, right?
Mm-hmm.
I miss Animal Kingdom camp. No,
what
I mean,
what I'm trying to say is you don't like having me around.
I love having you around.
I understand. I'll just go live in the forest.
I love having you around. Otherwise, I'd have to carry my own bag today.
Would you like it back?
No, thank you. Well, that was fun.
Very.
Again, I don't make it out here very often to Conservation Station. Oh, the cotton top tamarinds are delicious. Hello, thank you. You too. We're gonna have to eat fast though, because we're gonna have to go. We're gonna leave here at 1 o'clock.
What time is it? 10:36.
Really?
Yeah. What are we going to do for the next 2 hours?
We can check out Flight of Passage.
Okay.
Or Navi River.
Ooh, the
lines. It could happen.
The tree lines. Turn it to the
probably not going to do that. Thank you guys so much for joining us this morning from Disney's Animal Kingdom. Thank you to Nicholas for
carrying your stuff.
For carrying my stuff and for teaching me how to draw. Don't forget, what sword is it? It's the, I remember the hashtag, Protect the Pride. I think if you go to disney.com/protect the pride, you can find out more about the conservation efforts for the lions. Are we going to be live again today? I don't think so. We're going to have to leave a little bit earlier today, but I appreciate you guys watching and sharing and inviting friends and not laughing at my drawings all too very much. Thank you guys so much. Oak. Hope you have an amazing weekend. I love and appreciate you. Asante sana. Squash banana.
Peace out.
See ya.